My name is Aaron Cairo. I'm a sponsored skateboarder from the San Francisco Bay Area. And today, I'm gonna teach you how to do a shove it. Welcome to the world of skateboarding. Welcome to How to Skateboard for Beginners. You're gonna learn one of the very first, most essential skateboard tricks, the shove it. The first step to getting a pop shove it down is learning the foot position, what's going on here, and understanding how your front foot and your back foot work together to make the board do that shove it motion and land perfectly right underneath you, so you can perfectly right underneath you put your foot down, both feet, and land on the board. So your front foot is right there, and you're gonna be with the ball of your foot. The ball of your foot and the majority of your weight is gonna be on the front foot. Then your back foot is gonna curl over the side with your toes around the side of it, just like that, as if your fingers were going around the side of that board and then you were pulling it back. You're gonna do that with your toes. So in order to do that, your back ankle's gonna turn like that, and it's gonna shove straight back, just like that. That is the motion. So your front foot is gonna be on there, similar to my hand on this board, which is causing it to rotate. It's causing stability on there, you see? So your foot is there, and it stays close to the board, and it stays very flat. You're not bringing it up, you're not kicking off to the side, nothing. Flat on the board. So you got that, you got your front foot on there, it's very flat, you jump up just the slightest bit, you just shove that board backwards, boom. You can practice this on a board without trucks and wheels, you can practice it on the grass, definitely wear a helmet, elbow pads, knee pads, wear all the protective gear, because if you're a brand new skater and you're going and then you shove it and then you fall down, I don't want it to be the day that you decide skateboarding is too hard for me, I'm not gonna do it. In fact, you're never going to decide that. So just don't do that. Bend your knees as you're on the board. That's another thing that's gonna help you out a lot. When your knees are bent, your center of gravity is lower, and your ability to balance back and forth, side to side, is much improved. See, I'm 6'2", and I fall straight to the floor. If my knees are bent, what does that make me? Like 4.5? And you're falling, you would only fall to your knees, and you have the knee pads on, so you're good to go. So after you've learned to shove it and you've got that down, you're feeling good about it, we're gonna add a pop to it. The pop in the shove it makes the trick way, way harder. Just to shove it, very simple. But if you add hitting the tail on the ground, making the board go into the air and then turn, and with your front foot on the board like that, there's a lot more going on, and there's a lot more chances for disaster. So you put your ball of your foot like right there. It's very similar to the shove it. The only thing you're adding in is the pop, right? So your front foot is the same, kind of the same jump, only you're gonna jump higher because your board's gonna be going higher and popping up higher. You have your front foot there, your back foot like that. You give it the pop, just a quick shove around, and then it goes like that. Your front foot is a point of stability. It holds on the board and keeps it there. And you can drop it, boom, easy, no problem. So that's the pop shove it. You can do practice steps by just taking your back foot and just making it shove. For both the shove it and the pop shove it, do that practice step. And then when you get really comfortable at that, let's say you do that practice step maybe 20 times. Spend a good amount of time on it, it'll help you. And then put your front foot on and then do a little jump. And then put your front foot back on and land it. Front foot on, pop shove it, land. And you get that, you're golden. If you can't get that and you're struggling with getting your front foot back on, go back to the earlier practice step and give it some more time. Maybe 20 times was not enough. Maybe you need to do 40 times. And then eventually, with practice, it will make perfect. And you'll get it, you'll land with both feet. You've got it and you're golden. So I can't think of any other advice to give you other than that. So we're gonna go to the comments on Instagram and we're gonna see what people are struggling with on the shove it, and we're gonna answer it now. First question says, the board seems to go in front of me and I can't seem to keep it under me. Common problem. So you're shoving the board like this and it's kind of going way out too far. It's all about the quick speed of your back ankle. So if your front foot is here and your back foot is here and you go like this, there's not so much pop involved, but it's just straight back, right? Vitally important that you learn that one first. So you're just like that on the side and you're just pulling it back. Literally just just do this with your hands. You can get a good idea of how it would work. And then you go, okay, now I'm gonna do that with my feet, straight back. Well, there's only so much space it can go. It can't shoot too far in front of you. And especially if your front foot is there, it's a control point to hold that board there. All right, so I hope that helps you. If it doesn't, send in the skate support video. I got you. Okay, the next one from Braille Army Bot. Shout out Braille Army Bot, Braille Army Plus member. She says, commitment, rotation, and pop is perfect. In order to commit on this, it just takes a lot of practice. Commitment is all in here. It's in your noggin. Just practice it a lot. That's where just the regular shove it before the pop shove it comes in is good. And then as you learn to pop it, you want to get pop shove it's higher. Well, it's then more motion down. The harder you pop down, the less you need to go back, because your board is going up like this. And if you pop too far down and too far back, you're going to do a 360 shove it. And that's a whole nother tutorial video. I can't land with both feet on the board. And then another person said, I can't get my back foot to land on the board. Great. So I bet you probably both of you guys are going through a very similar thing. It's probably you've done this practice step where you're kicking your foot and leaving your front foot on, and then you're doing a little bit of what's called like chicken foot, where you can't put your back foot back on the board because you're scared or whatever. You have to build yourself up to it, right? So have your front foot on there, have your back foot on there, just go boom. And when you do that practice step, you have to break yourself out of that mentality. Probably a good way to do it would be to do the shove it without the trucks and wheels first, and then take it to a board. You're building yourself up. You can take it to the grass or any kind of carpeted area, put your board down and on that carpet, nice and safe. Then you can just go around and get that confidence built up. So you got to shove it back and bend your knee so your back knee goes up, and then put it down. That's another point. A lot of people think that, oh, I'm skateboarding, the skateboard goes in the air, I need to jump. And yeah, you can jump, but you can also just bend your knees. I think it's more in bending your knees than it is in jumping. So if you just go shove it back and bend your knee's already bent because it's shoving back. You just leave that back foot in the air and then just carefully place it back down on the tail. And the more practice you get at that, the more confidence you're gonna build up and the better you're gonna be at it. Oh, here's a really good one. Steve says, are you supposed to jump at an angle to catch it, or when is the flick supposed to spin in front of you? Great, so the harder you spin underneath you and just straight back, it will go just directly under you. You want to get it so it's going directly under you, but let's say you can't, and every time it's like kind of jumping forward, yeah, you can jump forward, but what you really want to do is just correct your back foot to go super far, just straight back, not down, straight back, and it will stay directly underneath you. Okay, the next customer says landing on the board while moving. Okay, so to get this one down, it's vital that you're very, very good at doing the shove it not moving, and then very, very good at just riding your board. And then essentially what it breaks down to is you're just putting those two together, riding the board, doing a shove it, and landing back on it while riding the board. You also gotta make sure you're not turning your shoulders either way. Keep your shoulders straight, lift up with your front foot, and just shove your back foot back. It's all in that ankle. So you get that, and then you do it with a little bit of speed. And you got it, just the tiniest amount of speed, and then a little bit more speed, and a little bit more speed, and faster, and then you got it. You're a skateboard champion. So to recap the shove it, practice with just your back foot, just the shoves, then put your front foot on there, and practice shove it, and take your back foot off. I love that practice step, because all you really need to do from there is bend your back knee and commit. You have to have the mental attitude, okay, I'm going to land this trick. So put your front foot on there, put your back foot on there, boom. That's just the mental attitude that you're taking before you try that trick, and you're gonna make it work. Just bada boom, bada bing, beautiful shove it, land it, put both feet on, land and roll away into the sunset. I hope you guys are having a blast on this series. I hope a lot of people are learning how to skateboard. with the advent of Olympic skateboarding, you can win a gold medal by learning how to ride this. How crazy is that? And as you guys are at the skate park and you see some new skaters beginning to learn how to skate, support them. Say, well done, it's awesome. We're creating a very welcoming, open community where anyone is welcome to learn how to ride a skateboard. And I thank each and every one of you who have decided to take up skateboarding. It's an awesome thing. You will love it. The better you get, the more fun you'll have. And I hope you're enjoying these videos. I'm working on making a tutorial video every single Tuesday. If you're new to the Braille Skateboarding channel, we do upload every single day at 10 a.m. So check it out. And every Tuesday, at the very least, will be a tutorial video. If you're learning to skate, subscribe, like, check out all those videos right there. And please leave me a comment below, because I need feedback from you to make better videos, because I need to know what you guys want to see, what you're struggling with, so I can answer your questions. Thank you so much. I'll see you in the next video.